Hi there, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. We begin with the Bedford death investigation. We are now learning the names of those killed in a home over the weekend. Police found the bodies of 34-year-old Nina Obakov, 8-year-old Catherine Obakov, and 6-year-old Elizabeth Obakov in that home at 17 McAfee Farm Road Saturday after a 911 call was made. According to the medical examiner, the two girls were the victims of a homicide, and the manner of the mother's death has not yet been confirmed, but it appears to be a suicide. It appears the mother shot her two daughters and then turned the gun on herself. We know each of the victims were shot in the head. Bedford school superintendent says the two girls who live at that address attended the Riddlebrook Elementary School. They will have grief counselors available all week if anyone at the school needs to talk. Well, right now, a Raymond man is being treated for serious burns in a Boston hospital suffered while trying to put out a fire at his home. This was the scene on Gertrude Avenue around 8 o'clock last night. As you can see, flames consumed and then destroyed the home. Firefighters say the homeowner tried to put the fire out using a blanket and in the process seriously burned his hands. Nashua police arrested a man for allegedly firing several shots in the city. Last week, police were called to Dickerman Street for a report of gunfire. Residents reported hearing numerous shots, and officers did find spent shell casings in the road. James Colby is now charged with reckless conduct after police found a gun and ammunition along with other evidence linking him to the shooting. He was released on bail and will face a judge in May. Rochester police are still searching for the man who stole a cash box from a group of Girl Scouts. Pierre Thibault of Haverhill, Massachusetts, reportedly grabbed the money while the girls were setting up their cookie booth at the Walgreens on South Main Street. Police arrested this woman for allegedly driving the getaway car. She is facing a judge today. Troop leaders say even though this experience, the girls still set up shop and continued to sell cookies. An alleged road rage incident leads to charges against a Jaffrey man. It started after Shane Lafreniere allegedly cut off another driver on the Ammaskeg Bridge in Manchester. Witnesses say Lafreniere then pulled up next to the driver on Canal Street, pointed a gun at the other car with two young children, age 1 and 4, inside. Police never found the gun, but they did find a knife inside Lafreniere's car. Starting tonight at 5, the government has rested its case against Joukhar Tsarnaev, ending with testimony that moved many jurors to tears. And we'll have much more on that breaking news out of Bedford. We have just learned the names of the mother and children killed in what appears to be a murder-suicide. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.